In Ohio, a developing mystery that has left police puzzled. A search is underway this morning for an entire family missing since last week. Police found traces of blood in the home of the Central Ohio family, but they say there's no sign of abduction. 32-year-old Tina Herman, her daughter Sarah, 10-year-old son Cody, and Herman's friend, 41-year-old Stephanie Sprang, were last seen Thursday. Neighbors are certainly hoping all four will be found safe. Joining me now to talk about the investigation, criminal profiler Pat Brown. Pat, good morning.
Good morning, Alex.
All right. What are the questions that investigators are asking themselves right now as they try to search for this family?
Well, they're really going to be looking heavily at the forensic evidence. They're going to be finding how much blood was there. Does this indicate somebody would be dead at this location or severely injured? Because they're saying it's not an abduction. The only way it could not be an abduction is if one of the parties got injured and then they just all left on their own, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me. They're going to be looking at those vehicles to see if there's any blood in either one of those vehicles, because if somebody left with that amount of blood, that's been around the house, you would think it would also end up in somebody's vehicle, either one of those two vehicles or another person's.
Yeah, and that amount of blood would certainly suggest a violent end, but cops say it does not appear that there was a forced entry into that home. What does that say?
Well, that says to me that's likely either a crime was committed by one of the parties in the home, which would be probably one of the women, or it could be an accident with a child and maybe a weapon or something that went off and somebody freaked out, or it could be somebody that knows the women well enough. And of course, people would say then they're going to be looking at the boyfriend, that he'd be the number one person that they'd be checking in with on that. And the most interesting thing about this case is that the dog is missing. And who takes a dog with them from a crime scene? I mean, that's very, very unusual. Only person that usually would do that is somebody who cares about the dog. So I think the police are going to be looking heavily at, the owners of that dog.
FBI and the Center for Missing and Exploited Children are working with the Ohio State Highway Patrol. How do these agencies all work together? I mean, what does the Highway Patrol have to do? Do they set up just those Amber Alert type of things all up and down the highways?
Right. They're really concerned, especially about these children, that if somebody has abducted them, the only purpose for abducting the children would be that they were witnesses to this crime. Of course, you'd ask, if they were witnesses to a crime in the home, why weren't they just killed there, which is usual, like a home invasion? Why would they be taken? The other possibility is that if it was something more involved with the people in the home, then that would be the mother taking the children and going on the run, so the children would be in a safer situation in that case. But of course, they still have to, they're looking out for, there's still obviously an injured party here, at least one, if not all four. If it's somebody who came into the home, somebody who knew one of the women, then you're talking about all four are in danger. So, I mean, they really want to get to these, especially the children, as quickly as they can, do what they can.
Absolutely. All right, Pat Brown, thank you so much.